But yes, I'm positive that we should have positive feedback. We've even submitted legislation for the conditions, which is one of the requirements that they wanted. So we have done everything that Curacao did in Aruba, basically, to meet that point, to continue the discussions on the third tranche for the conditions.
So how much money have you received so far from the Dutch government?
We've received a second tranche was about 60, 40, I think about between 90 million guilders for the year.
So the liquidity support from the Dutch government is really helping St. Martin?
In addition to our own, yes. I'm not going to lie, yes, the liquidity support did help. And
but we can't do it on our own.
With the current income, our income has now decreased to about half the amount. So typically we get between 35 and 40 million guilders. Mm. Our income has now decreased to less than half, so about 18. Last month was about 18 million. 2 months ago was about 20.
Look, I know they watch this program also too in The Hague. And the thing I'm saying here is that you as Minister of Finance, could you have done it without the Dutch government's financial support?
If we had gotten the loan that we wanted to float, I believe we could have made a very significant, we could have had significant gains. The loan that I was floating was about 75 million guilders, and the third tranche money from the Netherlands would be only 62 million guilders. So I believe that, yes, if we were allowed to use the tools that we have available, we could have made significant gains. I am appreciative of the support. I think the conditions are very stringent, especially for these times, especially if you compare them to the conditions set in the Netherlands itself. Bonaire, Statia, and what was the other one?
Ceiba.
And Ceiba. In addition to that, if you look at the conditions set for their European partners, France, Spain, Italy, and so forth, You can't find a comparison to that of St. Martin, Aruba, and Curaçao.